Hello everyone, welcome back to Noteworthy ENT. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the anatomy of tympanic membrane. So, tympanic membrane is a membranous structure which separates the external ear from the middle ear. So, this tympanic membrane is a pearly white or a grayish white membrane which is slightly oval in shape, being broader above. It is placed obliquely in the canal. Placed obliquely means that the posterior superior part is placed more laterally and the anterior inferior part is placed more medially. So, this tympanic membrane forms an angle of around 55 degrees with the floor of the external auditory canal. Coming to the dimensions of tympanic membrane, the longest diameter is around 9 to 10 millimeters, with the shortest being 8 to 9 millimeter. So the longest diameter is from the posterior superior area to the anterior inferior area, whereas the shortest one is perpendicular to this line. And the thickness of tympanic membrane is 0.1 millimeters. Now most of the circumference of the tympanic membrane is thickened to form a fibrocartilaginous ring, and this ring is known as the tympanic annulus or the annulus tympanicus, and this annulus is lodged in a groove in the tympanic bone which is known as the tympanic sulcus or the sulcus tympanicus, and this sulcus does not extend all around the tympanic membrane. It is deficient in an area superiorly, and this is known as the notch of Rivenus. From the superior limits of the sulcus, the annulus becomes a fibrous band, and these fibrous band attach to the lateral process of the malleus, and these are known as the anterior malleolar fold and the posterior malleolar folds. These malleolar folds, they divide the tympanic membrane into two parts, an upper triangular shaped area known as the pars flaccida or the shrapnel's membrane, and a larger inferior part which is known as pars tensa. As you can see from the diagram also, this shrapnel's membrane, this does not have a annulus around it. Before proceeding further, let us have a look at what all structures we can see through the tympanic membrane. So, this is the left tympanic membrane, and through the tympanic membrane, we can see the lateral most ear ossicle, that is the malleus. The handle of malleus can be seen through the tympanic membrane. And if you look carefully, we can also see a glimpse of the incus and the head of stapes, and this being the incudostapedial joint. And there is a cone of light in the anteroinferior compartment. On carefully observing, we can also see the shadow of the eustachian tube. So, malleus, incudostapedial joint, cone of light, eustachian tube opening. Now, this pars tensa is concave towards the ear canal, and the maximum point of concavity or the indentation is at the tip of handle of malleus, this point, and this is known as the umbo. Now let's have a look at how a tympanic membrane is divided into quadrants. For division, we draw a line parallel to the handle of malleus and another line perpendicular to this line. This divides the tympanic membrane into four quadrants. This being the left tympanic membrane, this is the anterior superior part, anterior inferior part, posterior superior, posterior inferior part. So two lines, the vertical line parallel to the handle of malleus, another line perpendicular to this, dividing the tympanic membrane into four quadrants. Now, this tympanic membrane is composed of three layers: the outer epithelial layer, middle fibrous layer, and the inner mucosal layer. Now, this diagram, this is a coronal section of the ear. So, this being the fibrous annulus. So, as you can see, the outermost layer is the outer epithelial layer. This is the continuation of skin of the external auditory canal. And the innermost layer is the continuation of the mucosa of the tympanic cavity. Lastly, the nerve supply of the tympanic membrane. Both the lateral and medial surfaces have a different nerve supply. Nerve supply of lateral surface is similar to that of external auditory canal, that is, the anterior part is supplied by the auriculotemporal nerve, which is a branch of the mandibular division of trigeminal nerve, and the posterior part is supplied by the auricular branch of vagus nerve, also known as Arnold's nerve or the Elderman's nerve, whereas the medial surface is supplied by the tympanic branch of glossopharyngeal nerve, which is also known as Jacobson's nerve. So this completes the anatomy of tympanic membrane. Kindly do give your feedback or if you have any queries or suggestions in the comment section below. Thank you.